we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section complex analysis. The problem is on Cauchy's integral formula. This question has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020 and it is from the section B. The problem is, let f be a holomorphic function, that means an analytic function, on the disk, the set consisting of z belongs to C, the set of complex numbers such that mod z less than 2. Assume that the only zero of f in the closed disk, the set consisting of z belongs to C such that mod z less than or equal to 1, and it is a simple zero at the origin. Assume that the only zero of f in this closed disk is a simple zero at the origin. Let gamma be a positively oriented circle, that is the set of all z belongs to C such that mod z is equal to 1, that is the unit circle. The integral taken round gamma of dz by fz equals, we are given four options. Option 1, 2 pi I times f prime 0. Option 2, 2 pi I times f double prime at 0. Option 3, 2 pi I by f prime 0. Option 4, 2 pi I by f double prime 0. Let's now discuss the solution of this problem in detail. We have an analytic function f on the open disk d1, the set of all z belongs to C such that mod z less than 2. This is your open disk d1, and it is given fz is analytic in this open disk, and we are also given d2, the set of all z belongs to C such that mod z less than or equal to 1. This is your d2, this is your d2, and gamma is a positively oriented circle given by z belongs to C such that mod z is equal to 1. What is this gamma? Gamma is the boundary of the domain D2. It is a closed domain, in that the gamma is the boundary, which is a positively oriented circle given by mod z is equal to 1. So this is your circle and this is your positive orientation of that circle gamma. Now you observe that D2 is contained in D1. D2 is contained in D1. F of z is analytic in D1. Therefore, F of z is also analytic in D2. F of z is analytic inside and on gamma. On gamma, since D2 is contained in D1. So, F of z is analytic in the closed disk D2, and gamma is a positively oriented circle which is the boundary of the domain D2. Therefore, f of z is analytic inside and on gamma. We continue in the next slide. We have f is analytic inside and on gamma, right? And given that f has only one simple zero, only one simple zero, that means zero of order 1, at the origin, that is z is equal to 0, which lies inside gamma. Agreed. Then in that case, f of z can be written as z minus 0 into g of z, because it is a simple 0 at z is equal to 0. And that is z times g of z, where this g of z is not g of z will not vanish anywhere inside and gamma, and g of 0 is not equal to 0, and where g of z is analytic inside and on gamma, and g of 0 not equal to 0. Now let's take the integral taken round gamma dz by fz, that is equal to integral taken round gamma dz by z times gz, because f of z is equal to z times gz. This can be written as integral taken round gamma 1 by g of z by z minus 0 dz. You notice that 1 by g of z is analytic inside and on gamma, and g of 0 is not equal to 0. So you can now we apply Cauchy's integral formula. So by Cauchy's integral formula, you get 2 pi I times the value of 1 by g of z at z is equal to 0, that is 1 by g of 0. This is by Cauchy's integral formula. So what is g of 0? So we have f of z is equal to g times z times g of z. Agreed? Take the differentiation with respect to z on both sides, then you will get f prime z is equal to g of z plus z into the derivative of g of z, that is g prime z. Now put z is equal to 0. If you put z is equal to 0, f prime 0 is equal to g of 0. G of 0, and g of 0 is not equal to 0. So therefore this answer 2 pi I into 1 by g of 0 will become 2 pi I into 1 by f prime 0. So the integral taken round gamma dz by fz is equal to 2 pi I into 1 by g of 0 from here, and g of 0 is f prime 0, that will be equal to 2 pi I by f prime 0. Let's look at the options. Our answer 2 pi I by f prime 0 appears against option 3. Therefore, our answer is option 3. So that is a very interesting question from the complex analysis, and the question is based on the Cauchy's integral formula. I hope that you have understood the solution of this problem and go on working out some more problems on the applications of Cauchy's integral formula and the Cauchy's integral formula for higher derivatives. And I wish you all the best. Thank you.